Maybe people think that scientists are quite nerdy, people closed in their lab. Maybe we are, but I met during my job a lot of international people that like to share knowledge and also their culture, their traditions. So we are really open and funny despite our nerdiness. Hi, I am Laura and I come from Italy. I'm here in Dresden since 2018 to study for my PhD project. I am a third year PhD student and I am studying retina regeneration in the zebrafish. The retina is a carpet of neurons that line the back of our eyes, and these neurons allow us to see the world because they catch the light that enters the eye. We are studying with the zebrafish, which is a master of regeneration. He is a very nice model that can repair and regenerate several parts of its body, like the nervous system, the bones, and other organs of the body. We always try to avoid animal research when possible, but sometimes we cannot exclude it. And however, every single experiment that involves the use of animals really is carefully examined by a dedicated committee, which is an ethical committee that has to give its approval before we really do the research. Basically, when I'm starting my day, I'm checking the emails. And then usually I update my lab book. I write down what I did the day before. I've been working here since December 2018, so I've been working for 2.5 years. I was quite new in the field when I started the PhD, because when I was a student, I used to study still neuroscience-related topics, but very different ones. But then I moved to Dresden, since I'm really in love with vision research, in particular the retina architecture and retina function. So I decided to change topic and I started here. I usually use a microscope to see the tissue, a lab coat to protect myself in the lab. And what biologists use most frequently is the pipette. It's like a magic wand that we use to take solutions, water and stuff, yeah. Research is very difficult because you are trying to explore the unknown. So it looks like sometimes walking in a dark room where you don't really see. And so you have to orient yourself in this darkness. It might be exciting because, you know, it's kind of mysterious. That's why I'm doing also this job. But sometimes it might be a bit tough because experiments do not work. It might be sometimes frustrating. But when an experiment really works, it's really exciting and extremely rewarding. My main technique that I use during my work is called immunohistochemistry. And it's a technique with which I highlight some characteristics in a tissue, which in this case will be the retina. So this will include taking some sections of the retina that I put here in a chamber with a special solution that allows me to see some characteristics in the tissue. My favorite thing to do when I'm working is to do microscopy research, because when I am at the microscope, I can have a look at the retina, which is a very beautiful tissue. And that's something that really motivates me in my research, the beauty of the retina. The retina is beautiful because you can clearly see that it's divided in several layers. Here we have the outer nuclear layer that hosts rods that allow us to see in dim light, and they are the majority of photoreceptors in the retina, and the cones that allow us to see the colors. They have this kind of antennae that you see here and also here, where light is processed in the first step. Light does not come from here, but actually light comes from here. So it travels through the layers of the retina and strikes the photoreceptors here. Then these photoreceptors connect to the horizontal cells, but also to the bipolar cells. And this connection is important to further process the light stimulus and to transmit it finally to the output of the retina, which are the retinal ganglion cells. And the retinal ganglion cells are neurons that have a cable, which is called axon. And all the cables of these guys collect into the optic nerve, which is kind of a highway that connects the retina to the brain, where light is further processed back here, where there's the primary visual cortex. We share a lot of genes with the zebrafish, which is unbelievable, but we really share a lot of genes. So we say that the zebrafish is evolutionarily related to humans, and that's why we use it as an animal model. Researchers always try to find alternatives to the research in animals. In my specific case, we are talking about a very specific phenomenon, which is regeneration of the retina. And even though regeneration occurs in a very specific tissue, which is indeed the retina, it always requires the complex interaction between not only the nervous system itself, which is the retina, but also other systems in the body that might be the blood vasculature or the endocrine system. We are all made of different systems and different organs that really interact in a complex manner. And so this complex interaction that occurs in an entire animal cannot, as far as we know now, be recapitulated in a dish, so in another kind of model that is not an animal. There are many diseases of the retina, like retinitis pigmentosa or age-related macular degeneration, which affect millions of people worldwide. It's very interesting because zebrafish can repair their retina, so they can restore their neuronal architecture in the retina, which is not possible in humans, for instance. And so my research is focused to understand how is this possible in the fish, with the hope in the future that these basic findings can be translated to the human research to really treat these vision loss diseases that affect humans. Thank you for visiting me at work today. Here are two additional videos. One is about the importance of the bees, and the other one is about how he's studying medicine in Dresden.